Hey everyone, we're here with Lauren, our very own water jet master, and today we're going to learn on how to use the water jet.
When we have something that we can't cut with our laser cutters, we use our Omax water jet. It shoots 40,000 psi of water at a part. It can cut almost anything ranging from polycarbonate to metal. In addition to the high pressure water stream, it mixes in an abrasive sand called garnet to help get a smoother finish around the edges. Let's walk through how to use the jet in 10 easy steps. Once we've opened our part in Omax layout, clean the drawing to make sure that our file is primed to be water jetted. Go to the Clean Part button, check off every box, and then click Go. Next, set the quality of your cut. This represents how smooth the edges will be when the cut is completed, with 1 being the roughest and quickest, and 5 being the smoothest and slowest. Using the water jet, we almost always use quality 3 in order to make our cuts. Create your path using the Generate Path function. Ensure your path begins cutting in sections that will be cut off, which can be seen by zooming into a part. If your part might fall through the water after being cut due to its size, add tabs. Click the Tab function and click on your part where you'd like the tab to be. This allows it to stay connected but easily removed from the overall piece later. Open your path and make and set the starting point. This is typically the bottom left corner. Then, select the type of material from the drop-down list and set the thickness. Now that your path is ready, you can begin adding your material to the water jet. Ensure that it is flat and securely clamped down. Move the nozzle to your desired starting point, and then use the 0X buttons and 0Y buttons to zero the water jet. Ensure that the water jet nozzle is the correct distance away from your part by lowering it until the focusing tool can just slide under the nozzle. Right-click on the Cut function to do a dry run in order to see if the water jet nozzle will bump into anything and will fit over your material. Now that everything looks good, you can make the cut. Make sure the water is above the part and always be ready to pause the water jet if needed. And there you have it! That's how you cut a part using the Invention Studio water jet.
If you're looking for any more information on our water jet, you can always ask Lauren or any other of our PIs around the studio. Also, you can always look on our wiki page.